have arrived. I will now observe how skilled you two really are.
You're so arrogant. Why are you always looking down on us?
Oh, I do apologize. But you are so tiny, Aaron, and I am so much taller.
Not talking about height. I'm talking about your attitude. You're doing this on purpose, aren't you?
All right, all right. It's not important. Let's just get going.
What the? Are you on her side now?
Of course he is. He did fall in love with me after all.
Whoa, hey, you two can catfight all you want, but don't drag me into it.
No, no. There is no need to hide your feelings. This place looks like it's overflowing with creepy crawlies. Faith, you will go first and protect me, won't you?
Hey, don't get carried away, you big stupid dumb idiot!
You're so cruel, but it feels so good!
Hey, seriously! What's with that reaction? It's super creepy, right, Fang?
We talk too much.
What? I do not talk too much. When have I ever talked too much, huh? Tell me!
Boy, I wonder. I'm exhausted all of a sudden.
Kill, kill, kill.
Stronger!
way down!
Here I come!
shooting slash.
Here I come. Let's go, Aaron.
I can't stop now.
Stay down.
Impossible.
I'm all right. I'm ready. Disappear.
Let's do this. Stay down. Get out of here. Gotcha.
I'm ready.
Get ready. Next.
My turn.
Lovey-dovey. Makes me sick. I hate jackasses with nothing but love on the brain. Just die already. It's what Ethel just said.
Huh? I can point out all kinds of problems with this situation, but can just saying kill over and over really mean all that? That's honestly the most shocking part of all this.
Besides, I don't need some weird girl telling me to kill. I think I can handle that on my own. Thank you very much.
Kill, kill. Kill, 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 kill.
Ethel says, no, I'm not telling you to kill. I'm telling you I'm gonna kill you.
Oh, I get it. But why does she just keep saying it over and over?
You mustn't ask such rude questions, Faint. I'm sure she has a very deep and meaningful reason for it. Otherwise, she would never speak in such an embarrassing way. Please, leave her be.
It is pretty embarrassing for sure. I have no idea what her reasons might be, but I feel bad for her.
Oh, well, The reason Ethel speaks like this is because she's too shy to speak normally.
Huh? How does that work? The way she talks now is way more embarrassing than if she just talked like a normal person. Can you try explaining it again and help us understand?
Kill!
Ethel, please wait!
What the hell just happened?
No idea.
Sorry.
I'm ready.
Let's do this. Next.
I come.
My turn. It's here.
Let's do this. Next.
I come.
You see my true power? My turn.
Get ready. Next.
Impossible.
My turn. Disappear.
Let's do this. Stay down. That was nothing. Decide to show your weirdo face again. What exactly do you want from us?
Kill! She says, didn't I just tell you I want you to die? You know, Ethel, you should try speaking more like a proper lady. You have such an adorable face. It's a real shame.
The way she talks is the least of her problems. I mean, threatening to kill us? You shouldn't say stuff like that, even as a joke. I think you need to go back to school. Communication 101, you know?
Kill! Bang! Look out!
Out of my way!
My turn!
Ah! do this!
Executing shooting splash!
Attacking us out of nowhere like that.
It's your own fault, really. You were poking at Ethel's most sensitive emotional weakness.
That's no excuse.
She's a fencer as well. She must be after this fury. It's completely common for fencers to battle it out for furies. Kill. Kill, kill, kill. Kill.
I don't give a crap about furies. All I want to do is destroy. That is what Ethel just said.
Destroy? But why would you?
Because that's how she was raised.
Kill, kill.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that. Anyway, let's retreat for now, Ethel. I'm afraid they have us at a disadvantage.
Kill.
Farewell, everyone. Until we meet again.
Those two started off weird and just went nuts from there.